OpenAI just dropped another bombshell and changed the AI video creation game forever when they released Sora 2. You've probably already seen dozens of Sora 2 clips in your feed. This model is capable of making videos better than anything we've ever seen before, beating Google's VO2, Kling AI, and even puts Runway Gen 4 up for a real battle. But while everyone else is making memes to post on TikTok, here are four ways you can use it to generate leads, no matter what type of business that you run. So in this video, I'm going to show you several creative ways so you can use Sora 2 not only to just generate leads, but close more deals and scale your brand. The first killer use case is being able to generate hyper-realistic UGC ads. UGC, or user-generated content, is the highest converting ad format right now because it feels authentic, like someone is actually vouching for your product. The problem is that it's often slow turnaround time and expensive to produce at scale, and most, if not all, businesses need it. Sora 2 changes that. You can now generate as many variations in a single ad concept in just minutes, testing different demographics, scripts, and product angles to find your winner. So first, all you need to do to get set up really is to go to openai.com, and then in the upper right corner, you're going to see login, which actually breaks down into ChatGPT, the API platform, and then Sora. You can clearly click on Sora here, where you're going to be able to see your feed and everything that you want to do, and it's going to populate a lot of the videos already, which you can see. You can just scroll down, and a lot of this stuff is already going to come up, but what you can do here is really just pick a cameo such as yourself, and then you can do a storyboard. You can also attach a file. You can do a number of different things, and then on this select right here, we have Sora 2 Pro, which is much higher quality, obviously, than Sora 2, but you can select these two here in order to conceptualize what you want to do. Orientation, you have portrait or landscape. So portrait will be good for vertical videos like Instagram, TikTok. And then we have landscape, which is more cinematic and obviously for most video formats like you're watching here right now on YouTube. Resolution, when you're doing prototyping, it's best to just go standard. And then when you really want to go for that fine touch, go for high. You don't always want to go for high for everything because it usually just takes a long time and it's unnecessary if you're just going to keep iterating on all that stuff. And then you have duration, which is pretty self-explanatory. And then you have video gens. If you learn more, you can actually see how many credits and things like that it's gonna take. So that's the first step here. And if you even click on your actual user profile, you'll actually see different drafts that I've been able to produce, which is awesome. A lot of this stuff is just so crazy that it's that realistic. I even showed my kids and they're like, "Dad, is that really you?" They're like, "I know my dad." So you can see right here in a few samples, and then we have drafts, things like that. We're just having fun. Even Snoop Dogg himself is doing things, which you should definitely check it out. It's pretty wild. And then if you were to go to the API platform, this is on the back end where if you have an API key and you use a platform such as N8N, or you want to build on top of it, you really just want to go into the video. So if we even do search, and we do Sora, we can do video generation with Sora. And the overview here, it's great to familiarize yourself with it, but obviously the Sora platform, Sora 2 at that, is one of the latest. Talks about the difference between Sora 2 and Sora 2 Pro. Talks about how to generate a video on the back end, or building on top of it rather. But we're not gonna dive too much into this stuff. There's a lot to be had here. And then there's also a prompting guide, which I definitely think you should check out, because as a prompting guide, this actually gives you the cookbook, or gives you a good sense of how to prompt the AI, especially Sora 2. Because you can really, really extract and get detailed prompts based on different video ads. You wanna treat yourself like it's a cinematographer. And one of the things that I love nerding about the most is that being able to utilize these AI models to solid prompt and context engineering around every single detail on what you want the AI model to do. But having been to film school, went to LA film school, I do video production. This is one of those things where I can just really nerd out, say like, use a red Komodo with a 35mm T2.5, because in Cine it's T, but little things like that to be able to really just hone in. So you could do wide, medium, tight type of shots. You could talk about the rule of thirds. There's a whole lot of things. So it's great to be able to also tie in different aspects there. And it talks about the little things here, like video length, video resolution, It also talks about you can do 90s documentary style, an old Swedish man sits in a study, going ultra detailed. So things like this, like look, lenses. If you talk about like vintage lenses and stuff like that, the AI model is going to respond to that. So let's say that we are ready to just turn on this lead generation engine and we're like, you know what? We're gonna come up with some UGC ads. Well, we're gonna do a little bit of a lead magnet. Go right into Instantly, and then you could just set up a campaign. So one of the things that we're gonna be able to do is to be able to actually create 10 different variants if we want to be able to generate and then send them over, because it's no skin off our back. We could just generate it and then say, hey, we can get your product. We could come up with some variants. We can do different UGC types of ads and then send it to them to see if they want to buy a bulk, a roundabout of different UGC ads. So that is the setup on Instantly. And then even to find leads, if you simply go to Super Search, we already generated a search right here. But effectively, if I were to filter for CEOs and CMOs, and then I even went after Shopify. This is a sample set. And obviously for video and privacy purposes, this is going to be blurred out. But if I were to sit here and find the emails and then enrich it and then add it to that campaign, this would definitely start the engine as far as reaching out to these people, for people that actually own e-commerce sites, just as an example. And these are not the only ones. You can reach out to a number of different UGC type of things. Like I have a good buddy of mine that owns a cinnamon shop in Idaho, and I can simply just grab one of his cinnamon rolls and say like, hey, this customer, like his cinnamon rolls are so good, right? And we can start to generate content around that. And then from there, once the reply actually comes in, you're gonna wanna hop over to something like N8N, where we can catch the reply. So from here, this is an example, but we can come in and we can actually see what they're saying. Like, sure, go ahead and send me some video samples. And then we can send this to an AI agent. The AI agent, we've built out the system prompt, basically say, you are a product information extraction assistant. Your task is to help scrape e-commerce product pages and extract the necessary information to generate product videos. And then we give the details around it. So we have a role. We are defining everything here, and then we're outputting a JSON array of the products found within that. This is the user prompt. We're basically saying, extract the product information from this prospect's reply. You can see right here everything that we're doing. And then we're gonna feed this into Sora 2 prompts. So from here, this is gonna be a JavaScript code node, and we're gonna prepare the information, and then we're gonna insert a prompt. You can see right here, this is the prompt. Authentic iPhone selfie UGC video. Gen Z woman unboxing product name, excited reaction, natural lighting. And then we have different ones. So what you could do is just feed this into ChatGPT and say, hey, this is gonna be the prompt. And then we're gonna format it in such a way to actually insert it into Sora. So we have the endpoint, which is what OpenAI calls for. You wanna do your credentials here. And then we actually have the prompt right here. And so we're gonna basically say, generate this. And then this is gonna be the input reference, which is gonna be, in this case, a cotton t-shirt. And then it moves on to the next thing. Now, on this particular thing, the way the API works is it's going to send the request. And on each of these, you could see that there's three items there. And then for each one, this is actually gonna do what you call polling the API. So we're gonna get a response after we send this. It's gonna say pending or in the queue. And it's going to check video status. From there, if it's not completed, it's gonna circle back. We're gonna wait another like 120 seconds or so to be graceful about it. And then we're gonna check again. So it's almost like if you're on a road trip and you have kids in your back seat, and they're saying, Dad, are we there yet? Dad, are we there yet? Dad, are we there yet? So from here, you're gonna basically be polling the API until it's done. And then we're gonna go ahead and send the reply out inside our campaign within the Unibox using the Instantly's integration that we have built by yours truly. Now, what you're really gonna need is a good, solid, strong prompt. Let's just say that we're selling a new productivity app. You can prompt Sora 2, generate a video of a Gen Z remote worker filming a get ready with me style type of vlog, showcasing how the app saves them 2 hours a day. You simply upload your product image, add the prompt, and then Sora 2 generates a video that looks like a real person filmed it on their phone. Here are some samples that I've generated using Cursor with Sora 2 MCP.
I'm not gonna lie, this little app has actually changed how I get stuff done. Let me show you. It breaks my day into blocks. I just hit focus mode and it keeps me on track. I swear it saves me like 2 hours every single day. I just check things off and keep moving. So yeah, big fan, highly recommend.
Okay, so this app literally gave me back 2 hours of my life today.
Just wrap my day and look, 2 hours and 8 minutes saved.
The automation alone saves me 2 hours every
every single day.
Next up is personalized and niche specific videos. Dynamic stock footage for landing pages is honestly boring and usually low quality at best. Ever since going to film school, once you see it, I mean, it just shines out like, oh, you know? But what if you can generate perfectly tailored, high quality video footage for every single niche that you target? You can do this with Sora too. Especially if it's with the API or MCP server, you can do this at scale for something like Cursor. So what you're gonna wanna do is go into Cursor, and if you haven't seen my video previously around Vibe marketing, you can set up your project in such a way that you have literally your whole code base, including prompts. You can have your Sora 2 set up. Another thing is Claude skills. And then another thing we have is MCP. If you're not familiar with MCP, it's basically like having a package toolbox available for your agents to be able to select whatever tool they want to be able to do the job. And this is exactly this part right here. So we're in Cursor settings. We have tools and MCP. And if I drop down, I've actually set up Nano Banana as well as Sora to be able to do these exact things. And you can see right here, we have 7 tools. So we have create video, remix video, get video status, list views, download video, which saves to your hard drive, save video, and then delete video. So these are really awesome, powerful tools. And I could just simply use natural language to be able to generate videos. And I can say, is it done yet? Things like that. I can say, I have this idea. It could pull in from Claude's skills of prompting, which is from the OpenAI cookbook. And then it'll start generating, and then it'll actually pull it, or it'll queue. So we can check just from here. And then it could save to your hard drive where you can then download the file, send it to the client, or upload it to a Google Drive, and you're basically done. So it's pretty simple to be able to just go dive in into an AI agent such as Cursor and just be able to generate personalized video based on a specific thing here. So imagine that you're a SaaS company targeting both real estate agents and financial advisors. Instead of generic videos, you can use Sora 2 via their API or MCP such as Cursor to generate a video of a busy real estate agent closing a deal in a modern office for one landing page, and then a focused financial advisor reviewing charts with another client for another. This level of personalization drastically increases trust and conversion. And just as a demonstration, what I did right inside Cursor was I basically told Sora or my AI agent to say, generate these videos with exactly this. And then you could see right here, we have the video. And then I was able to produce different variations here. So we have this one, we also have this one, and these are videos embedded. This is definitely a landing page to be able to do this. And you could see I'm on localhost 3000. So this is actually on my device, but I could send this to something like Vercel or Netlify or any other hosting platform to be able to send and make this website live. And then we have another variation here. So these are specific for real estate agents. So this is tailored video developed and generated by Sora 2. The other one is regarding financial advisors. You could see here, this is one of the landing pages that was generated. And then from here we have variant 2, and then we have variant 3. So I could very well say generate more variants and then it would embed it. I could actually customize this landing page a lot more. This was literally a one-shot prompt to say, do this, this, and this, base it on this tech stack, and then generate this video and then embed it in this video. And that's it. I could spin this up in a matter of seconds. Now, our third use case is a game changer for sales teams: AI-powered sales enablement. When a prospect has a common objection, your sales rep usually has to send a generic document or a long email of some sort. With Sora 2, you can pre-generate a library of short, hyper-specific video responses to every single objection, even so much as putting it on your website for a quick referencing, so you can educate your prospects more. Think of it like an instant high production FAQ library for your sales team. For my agency at Top of Funnel, the common questions that we get is how we implement our systems into various businesses, especially when we use tools like Instantly to send cold email, and how they work with us when we partner with them. Another video that you could produce is how your solution is different than your competitors. Instead of talking through it or sending them some long email and text, you can send them a video that you've generated with Sora 2 from either yourself as a cameo, or you could leverage your CEO or founder to do this as well to clearly explain. You can even use the Sora 2 MCP server to generate these videos at scale in a platform like Cursor, covering dozens of objections in a single afternoon. Again, It's all about the prompting. Now, for the fourth use case. This one I'm most excited about, and that is production level ads that you can use in paid ads. In just a couple hours, with some solid prompting and laying in the details of how we want the video to actually look, you can seriously produce some high quality, commercially ready videos in your business. You can see for yourself, I created a cameo of me and gave it many different types of ideas, styles, and ways to generate videos that can totally be used for commercials. Think of it like those holiday commercials where you can get really, really creative. Just as an experiment and proof of concept, I even gave it an old school clear Coca-Cola and prompted it with the polar bears to give it a little bit of unicorn magic and created a Coca-Cola commercial just to see what it can do. And you can see for yourself, it is definitely mind-blowing. Now, if you sell agency service or software and you want to get more in depth when it comes to actually using the software that I just showed you to generate tens of thousands of leads for your business, click here. In that one, we give you a full tutorial for Instantly.ai and learn everything you need to set all the technical stuff up, pull your first lead list, and build your entire campaign to start booking dozens of sales calls every single month. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you over there.